Everyone, myself Dr. Shweta Saxena from Department of Zoology, St. Wilfrid's College for Girls, Jaipur. I hope कि आप सभी लॉकडाउन को स्ट्रिक्टली फॉलो कर रहे होंगे और अपने अपने घरों में स्वस्थ और सुरक्षित होंगे. इस लॉकडाउन पीरियड को और भी अधिक वैल्यूबल बनाने के लिए आज से हम कुछ इंपॉर्टेंट टॉपिक्स को रिवाइज करेंगे. ये लेक्चर्स आपके अपकमिंग एग्जाम्स में हेल्प करेंगे और साथ ही अच्छे मार्क्स लाने में भी आपकी मदद करेंगे. सो वी विल स्टार्ट विद बीएससी फर्स्ट ईयर जूलॉजी पेपर 3rd. टॉपिक इज पार्थिनोजेनेसिस. लेट्स स्टार्ट. पार्थिनोजेनेसिस, व्हाट इज पार्थिनोजेनेसिस? पार्थिनोजेनेसिस इज कम्स फ्रॉम ग्रीक वर्ड पार्थिनोस विच मीन्स वर्जिन एंड जेनेसिस विच मीन्स creation, that is development without fertilization. We know that an ovum develops into a new individual only after fertilization, but many animals and plants are known to develop from the eggs without fertilization, is known as parthenogenesis, and the individuals so formed is called a parthenote. Parthenogenesis is common among lower plants, invertebrates such as nematodes, rotifers, ants, parasitic wasps, some bees, aphids, etc. Parthenogenesis was discovered by Charles Bonnet in the eggs of sea urchin. Parthenogenesis may be differentiated into two types. First is natural and second one is artificial. First, we will discuss about natural parthenogenesis. Natural parthenogenesis occurs naturally or spontaneously without any artificial induction. Natural parthenogenesis में egg को प्रेरित करने की आवश्यकता नहीं होती. Natural parthenogenesis regularly occurs in the life cycle of lower forms of animals. For example, rotifers, gall fly and aphids. Now, कुछ animals ऐसे होते हैं जिनमें सिर्फ parthenogenesis ही पाया जाता है, जबकि कुछ animals ऐसे होते हैं जिनमें reproduction के लिए parthenogenesis के साथ साथ sexual reproduction भी present होता है. So, on the basis of this, natural parthenogenesis may be of two types. First one is complete or obligatory parthenogenesis and second one is incomplete ya cyclic or facultative parthenogenesis. So first we will discuss about complete or obligatory parthenogenesis. जैसा कि नाम से ही इसके clear है, complete means ऐसे जो animals हैं उनमें केवल और केवल parthenogenesis ही reproduction का माध्यम होता है. Obligatory केवल कंपलसरी होगा कि ऐसे एनिमल्स केवल पार्थिनोजेनेसिस के द्वारा ही रिप्रोड्यूस करें. हेयर ऑर्गेनिजम्स रिप्रोड्यूस एक्सक्लूसिवली बाय पार्थिनोजेनेसिस. इन दीज फॉर्म्स ओनली फीमेल्स आर फाउंड, मेल्स आर जनरली एब्सेंट. एग्जाम्पल, डिलॉयड रोटिफर्स, गॉल फ्लाइज एंड सम स्पीशीज ऑफ अर्थवर्म. कंप्लीट पार्थिनोजेनेसिस इज also observed in lizard Lacerta saxicola americana and fish Carassius auritus gibelio, where males are totally absent and only females are found in nature. Now, incomplete or facultative या cyclic parthenogenesis. ये incomplete parthenogenesis उन organisms में होता है जो sexual reproduction भी कर सकते हैं. इन प्राणियों में पार्थिनोजेनेसिस एनवायरमेंटल कंडीशंस पर डिपेंड करता है. फॉर एग्जांपल, मिएस्टर जो कि फेवरेबल कंडीशंस में पार्थिनोजेनेसिस से रिप्रोड्यूस करता है, जबकि एडवर्स कंडीशंस जब आती हैं तो ये सेक्सुअल रिप्रोडक्शन को दर्शाता है. मैनी वेरिएशंस आर ऑब्जर्व्ड इन द पैटर्न ऑफ स्विच बिटवीन सेक्सुअल रिप्रोडक्शन एंड पार्थिनोजेनेटिक रिप्रोडक्शन. Such as gall flies shows alternate sexual form of reproduction with parthenogenetic generation every time. But in some others like rotifers, aphids, definites, etc. Sexual phase occurs after many parthenogenetic reproductive phases. Now, we can again classify natural parthenogenesis on the basis of chromosomal sets present in parthenotes. First one is haploid parthenogenesis or Arrhenotoccus parthenogenesis, and second one is diploid parthenogenesis or Thylotoccus parthenogenesis. First, we will discuss about Arrhenotoccus or haploid parthenogenesis. Here, the males arise from unfertilized egg by parthenogenesis and are haploid, while females arise from fertilized eggs and are diploid. For example, in bees, females are diploid with 32 number of chromosomes and males have only 16 number of chromosomes and are haploid. Other groups which shows this type of parthenogenesis are rotifers, hymenoptera, hemiptera, coleoptera and arachnida. Haploid or Arrhenotoccus parthenogenesis is also called as haplodiploidy because here both haploid and diploid forms are present. Now, diploid or Thylotoccus parthenogenesis. Here, parthenotes are diploid, which are developed by diploid but unfertilized eggs. It may be of two types, ameiotic thylotochy and second one is meiotic thylotochy. In first, ameiotic thylotochy, first meiotic division, which is actually the reduction division, is completely suppressed and the primary oocyte directly undergoes second maturation division, which is only a mitotic division. Such eggs contain diploid number of chromosomes and develop into new individuals without fertilization. For example, Isopoda, Daphnia, weevils and long-horned grasshoppers. Second, meiotic thylotochy. In this, the normal haploid egg development takes place during oogenesis, but later on, diploid conditions are achieved by restitution or by auto-fertilization. Now we will go for restitution. In this process, cytokinesis does not take place in the first meiotic division. In insect, order Lepidoptera, primary oocyte undergo normal reduction division till the movement of chromosome to opposite poles. But later, the karyokinesis is not followed by cytokinesis. As a result, after second maturation division, one diploid secondary oocyte and one diploid polar body is formed. The diploid ovum develops into a parthenogenetic individual. Now, autofertilization. In Artemia salina, one of the polar body fuses with haploid ovum. As a result, ovum becomes diploid. This process is known as autofertilization. This diploid ovum then gives rise to embryo parthenogenetically. Now, second type of parthenogenesis, that is artificial or induced parthenogenesis. Kuch organisms jo generally parthenogenesis से रिप्रोड्यूस नहीं करते, उनमें हम वेरियस स्टिमुलस के द्वारा पार्थिनोजेनेसिस को प्रेरित कर सकते हैं और इस प्रकार के जो आपका रिप्रोडक्शन है इसको हम आर्टिफिशियल और इंड्यूस पार्थिनोजेनेसिस कहते हैं. इन दिस फैक्टर्स विच इंड्यूसेस पार्थिनोजेनेसिस आर कॉल्ड पार्थिनोजेंस विच आर फॉलोइंग फिजिकल लाइक ब्रेकिंग टेम्परेचर शॉक्स यूवी लाइट्स chemical like salts, solvents, blood serum, fatty acids, etc. Mechanical means shaking and rubbing, and biological, which includes pseudo-fertilization. In this, entry of a sperm into egg without contributing its nucleus. That is, after penetration, a sperm disintegrates without mixing the egg nucleus. Now, in this chart, we can conclude our types of parthenogenesis on the basis of life cycle or on the basis of chromosomal sets in the parthenote. Now, significance. Parthenogenesis is the most simple and easy form of reproduction. It also serves as a means of sex determination in bees and wasps. But it limits the genetic diversity and weakens a species in long term. And it also checks on evolution. So these are the disadvantages of parthenogenesis. Now, thanks for hearing. Good luck. Stay home, stay safe. Thank you.